are returning to Total War, something of a root for this channel, and specifically to Total War Pharaoh. Notice, not a saga title. It's another Bronze Age game. I played this in the Early Access weekend. As we go through it, I will have thoughts, which I will share as we progress, about this game, about Saga, which now no longer exists. I have thoughts. Anyway, let us get started. We are playing as the Hittites.
It is most extraordinary.
Will I play as Egypt, as one of the Egyptian factions? Absolutely, later. But my plan is to play Hittites.
I will not let my kingdom be torn asunder.
Canaanites, and from Canaan to, well, playing as Egypt. So, what do we have here? Our first challenge is low happiness. So, we're gonna have to figure out something to do with that. We can't make a royal legal complex. Tax collector's office is not necessary yet. Do we want... I think what we want... There's a lot of building options, which I do, and... Oh! There we go. Okay, so, food. Let's talk about resources real quick. For those of you who are not familiar with Total War, Troy, food is one of our most important resources. This is what we use to cover our cost. So you can see here, generals, units, they all cost food. Stone is for building. Wood, also for building. Bronze and gold.
I breathe the air of truth and justice.
But they also are for units. Bronze for kind of mid-tier units, gold for high-tier units. Okay, let's look at our royal decrees. What do we do first? Well, obviously, on festivals, we need the improved happiness. So we're just going to kind of putter these three first.
King of Hatti.
And now, what are our pending actions? Outpost construction. Okay. I really like outposts. The whole outpost system is really kosher for me. However, I do want to say for anyone who wants to be playing Total War Pharaoh, if you do not use the outposts, you're going to suffer economically. So let's see. I could do this, which gives us garrison and siege holdout time. Could afford this, which gives us improved legitimacy. Legitimacy is very nice. I'm gonna go
law and order, but for whom?
Because this gives us improved resource production, and this one improved happiness. Legitimacy, improve garrisons. Resources. Which is okay. This is fine. Now then. Can we afford to build anything else? No. No, we cannot. Okay. It is time...
Righteous King of Hatti!
...for our first battle. So, we're gonna fight this on the field because first battle. But let's see. Oh, that's our guy. That's our guy. Cool, cool, cool. Probably not gonna use
him. Let's go.
I would rather fight a well-trained dog than a wounded rat. Tell the men to expect harsh resistance. Expect no mercy, for the desperate have none left to give. City the Second, on the eve of battle with Superluma the Second. Hope I'm pronouncing that right. I'm probably not. Okay, what do we have? We have general bunch of not bad infantry. Not bad. And a chariot. Chariots are not new to Total War, but I do have to confess, what embarrassing with how long I've been playing Total War games. This is the first game where I've ever actually managed to use chariots properly. So, you know, see what I can do. And watch. Having said that, I finally... Oh, that's right. Dynamic weather. Let's talk about the weather conditions. I really like the weather conditions. So let's wait. Current weather. Rain. Let's see. Dry. Dang it, I was hoping for a storm. Okay, let's actually take a look at our...
Their numbers are insulting!
To kill the enemy. We've got these Hittite tribesmen. Very nice. We have our Hattusan swordsmen. We have
swords!
Two of veteran Hattusan swordsmen. We have our general...
King of Hattusha!
And there's the man himself. That beard is not rendering very well. Our chariots.
They will fear our marksmen.
We have a driver, a spear wielder, and a shield wielder. This is accurate. Chariots were not always, I don't want to say not always very accurately portrayed in games, but they weren't just, you know, one man puttering along, yeeting things at the enemy with his free hand.
They will drown in a river of blood!
There was a driver. At least a crew of two.
Reinforcements arrived to support your army. Together, you can vanquish the foe.
They died today!
Just tire yourself out. Butter.
Destroy them!
Where the fuck are you running to? Stop it. Thank you. Jesus Christ.
Without fear, I do not fear death.
Okay.
Make them tremble!
No matter who we hit with our spearmen are going to get absolutely butchered. That's fine.
Destroy them!
Make them hurt!
Oh, you need to walk.
Victory awaits! Triumph awaits! Chariots maneuver!
Up here.
Wheels to position!
But yeah, this time is cavalry didn't really exist.
These trees give us cover!
Understandably, there was some essential bits of technology that had not quite been invented yet. Things like the saddle or stirrups. Invention of the stirrup, arguably one of the most pivotal inventions in military history.
They are no threat!
Because it allowed for the existence of heavy cavalry.
Place his chariots!
Okay, you can see the enemy trying to shape, trying to adjust. They know we're coming. But I don't care that they know. They're forming a box. Oh, that is adorable.
Carve through them!
So the thing about chariots, we'll talk about the thing about chariots once it's time to actually use them.
Chariots moving!
Which is coming. The time to use them is coming. Did we give the order to charge? Yeah. Patience.
He's down, please! We cannot move!
Position. Doesn't have to be so hot. Never surrender. Will make a difference.
Down. Down. As you can see, they are very here. They're very demanding. They're currently trying to climb into my lap.
Place his chariot.
That's enough. 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 Go lie down. Thank you. Christ on the post.
Get away! Strike with purpose. End this rabble! Chariots! Kill them all!
This was not supposed to happen!
I will not let Hattie falter!
Die, fools!
For Hattusha! For honor!
Chariots!
I do not want to die!
Death take you!
Tarhona guides my hand.
Swords!
Hattusha!
Bonebreaker! Go!
close fighting!
Lalvar did take you!
It's moving!
Yep. One unit of Hittite tribesmen. One of the priesthood's most well-kept secrets is their extensive knowledge of natural processes, and one of their most important doctrines is to use that knowledge to reinforce the impression of the god's divine power at work on the material world in the minds of the populace. In that, the Great Nile has been nothing if not obliging. Farmers measure the cycles of their life not following the progress of the seasons, but the mystical occasions when a priest would descend down the hollow shaft of the Nilometer and emerge either grim or triumphant. The intimations of famine, bounty, or ruinous flood during the season of inundation also spell out the tax collector's yield for the upcoming year, measured not in grain, but in coin. So we lost 165 men. Most kills went to the chariot, with 92 kills.
None will doubt our strength.
30 bronze and 2 legitimacy. So we're gonna take the replenishment.
Keep them in their bonds. I will not let my kingdom be torn asunder. I will live and die with you.
Okay. Hittite spearmen, Hittite axemen. Our bronze income is not that high, so I'm gonna take one unit of axemen.
Heed my summons! Come, let us safeguard Hati.
High mobility units are good units. Now, what can we build here? Oh, okay. Yes. And skill point.
For Hati's glory.
Okay, here we have. So, I don't necessarily agree with how things are laid out, but what we have here, kind of like the old system in Medieval 2. Now, what I'm gonna do, we're gonna focus on presence and ardor first. So this gives us a key reduction of level of -4%. And we're going to take this. Quicken recovery. If we are wounded, we're there for 2 turns less, and we will gain 25 experience per turn, which is nice for reasons I shouldn't need to elaborate, therefore will not. With that, let's end our turn and see what happens. Okay, we have some movement over there. Azira, I don't know how to pronounce it. Is moving, and so is Unutpa to the city of Bukasos. Okay, he just raided our plus 10 diplomatic relations with Tuana. Hold the... A lot of conquests. Yep. Our outpost was raided.
King of Hati, start the assault.
We do not have enough stone to fix it. But we are going to...
Time to move!
If not successfully wipe them out, then we are going to chase them out. And now we have to think about how we're going to expand. Our first priority, in my opinion, is that we need to take out... we need to take control of Zipalanda. The reason we need to take Zipalanda, they have two food provinces, a stone province, and gold. Both of which are things we really, really need. So, with that in mind, we need to take it from them. Because, bluntly, they're not going to give it to us. And since they won't be charitable and piss off, we're going to have to ask impolitely. Okay. So this is going to give us 125 food. This is going to give us 230 food. Okay. We'll use that food income to build up an army. And that army... Never mind. Nuaza wants to be our enemy. I guess we're going to war with Nuaza. Why do I say they want to be our enemy? Well, they're raiding us.
Righteous King of Hati.
So we're gonna putter over here.
For my people.
And this one we're just... That had to hurt.
Wurukata was with us. Great King of Hati.
So, yes. How many settlements Ankia has? Food and wood. Okay.
Righteous King of Hati.
We can make that work. I'm gonna add...
Let your worth show.
To some swordsmen.
At least we are in this together.
Leveling up. More mobility and charge bonus. With the chariot in our army, charge bonus is super important. Okay, next up. Legacy of Hati, plus 3 workforce growth.
Death is nothing to fear.
For Hati's glory.
Wait a second. Let's think about this rationally. Do I have to? You know what? Of course I do.
I serve Hati.
Lowers my happiness a lot. I have to drive him out. I did not want to be fighting war this early, but what choice do I have? Well, I did not want to be fighting another war this early. It's okay. No, it's fine. It's fine. I will crush the interloper. No, see, Altira, I can't let there just be peace because you've fled. Okay. 1046. I'm not getting chariots. 1025 units in total. Current total 15. Construct resources, type building, producing gold. I'm gonna take this one as an aspiration.
Great King of Hati.
Not a hard accomplish this. Because we're heading.
Come, brethren! It is time! Stand by me!
Okay, ships of war. As the cycle turns once again upon your land, the royal court convenes once more in the eyes of the gods. Close the subsection, state of the world, local deities. Commands, court, power of the crown.
My people come first. Servant of the people.
We're gonna go right there.
Strike hard. Make it count.
Oh, he's speedy.
Onwards.
But
charge at
is
them.
He speedy enough. Answer. Absolutely. Our casualties are going to be low, but you know what? I want to fight in the field. This will be our last battle, and then we'll take one turn to just adjust, get set, start the siege, and prepare to wipe Yuanza off the field. Which is good. Like, we take every food settlement we take improves the size of the army we can support, and the number of armies, because as you saw, even a general is really expensive. A lot of food goes into that. So, let's take a look at our
boxes.
I hope they don't make this too easy.
Okay, I like.
Ready for battle!
Militia, I like, but guys, where are your shirts?
Clubs!
Oh, good. The Caskians are wearing shirts. I can't believe people wear shirts.
Chariots!
They probably feel insecure. Wear shirts to make themselves feel more manly. I mean, don't wear shirts. Oh, Hello, where are you guys going?
They must have been scared to face us! Triumph awaits!
Chariots moving! Wheeling into position! Watch out for vipers!
Looks like it.
Ever faithful!
Be wary of their spears!
Wherever I'm needed. His name.
They died today.
To glory. Strike with purpose.
Kill them all.
Might and glory.
For the thousand gods.
Break them. Might and glory.
Break their spirits. I'll got you!
Hati will not fall.
Never surrender!
In Hati's name!
Never surrender! March, brothers! Break their spirits! Places, chariots! Kill them all! Triumph awaits.
Take that!
Chariots maneuver. Chariots moving.
King of Hati. Take heart.
Wheeling into position.
The thousand gods smile on us.
Places, chariots.
Thank you.
for the homeland!
We are being ambushed!
You all can't see it because I didn't have the camera on, but I have one dog circling me like a fuzzy vulture, and the other is taking up my recording room's entire room. Spoiled brat, so well done. So, okay.
Will doubt our strength.
So there's some tofu, 40 bras, 2 legitimacy, and again.
We must make use of them. I will not let my kingdom be torn asunder.
They are destroyed. So then, improve our upkeep production. 3 pending actions. Court action. Yes. Okay.
Shemsu Hor begins. It is the time to take stock
to the court
and
system.
Take note.
So, we are the Great King. Oh, we're the Great King. That's nice. So, what do I... I'm just going to make our quest a gossip.
Courts can make me feel uncomfortable, but I can count on you here.
Now then. Evil bronze. Which means our next war has to be against Sepinu, because they have a lot of gold and stone and food. Where's the bronze? Where's bronze? It's food. Ah, bronze here. The Bishna. Do I go after them? I guess I'll go after them next. Turn. Patience. Okay, we're actually looking at a battle. At a big old beep beep. Would be severely damaged. I'm actually going to save here, and we will pick up here in our next recording. So, everyone, thank you for tuning in. This is episode 1 of our Hittite campaign. A guest. All comers, who knows what will happen next? Stay tuned. Be good to each other out there.